actually, bro. Yo namah Hari Om. So yesterday we saw laha paraspai padam tanganav atmane padam. The lakara so this is given paraspai pada sanya and this is given atmane pada sanya. Okay, then he says anudata gnita atmane padam anudata. So this should be given, this is the pratyaya atmane pada pratyaya, this is paraspami pada pratyaya. Now this pratyaya to which dhatu will you give? You have to apply these pratyayas to a dhatu, to a root word. To which root word, what will be the pratyaya? How do you know? See, we are going to take bhu sattayam. Bhu sattayam. This is the dhatu we are going to take. Should we apply paraspami pada or should we apply atmani pada? How do you know? We have no idea. So, through the sutra he says, anudata gnita atmane padam. Anudata nitaha atmane padam. So the anudata and nit, anudata or nit, nit means nakara it. Okay, if the dhatu has nakara it or if it has a anudata ending, then it will have atmane pada, it will be atmane pada. It will give atmane pada, it will get the atmane pada sanya. Okay, then next swarita gnitah kartra vipraye kriya phale. Then swarita gnitah, next sutra he says swarita nitaha kartrabhipraye kriyafale. Swarita gita, like anudata gita, you have swarita or nit, swarita or nit. Then atmane pada sanya takes place. When does this atmane pada sanya takes place for anudata gita, swarita gita, anudata gita? Only when the kriya phala is kartra vipraya. Seventh case, all this. This is seventh case, this is seventh case, this is first. Kartra vipraya kriya phale. Only when the kriya phala is going to go to the karta. Kartrugamini kriya phale, if the karma, the karma you are doing, the result of it is going to be going to your own self, then it is a atmane pada. So with bhu you will bring in atmane pada. When will parasmi pada be applied? For that he says sheshat kartri parasmi padam. So now we have, if it is atmane pada, if it is atmane pada, then the dhatu should be, the dhatu should be anudata or swarita anudata nit, nit. It should be anudata or swarita or nit, it should be any of this. It should have to have anudata ending, swarita ending, nit ending or nit ending. Then it will be atmane pada. Now when will it be parasmi pada? So he says sheshat kartari
papa.
Sheshat kartari parasmai padam. Sheshat, if it is not anudata or swarita, it is udata. Udata and anything else other than angit and nit. So, angit, nit. It will be parasmai padam in kartari artha. In this is also in kartari artha. Okay? And sheshat means here kartravi praya kriyafale for atmanipada. Sheshat means when the kriyafala is not for the karta. That also you can take. Okay? So, when the karta, the kriyafala, the action you are doing, the result of the action you are doing is not going to come for your own self, then it is a parasmi pada. If it is going to go to somebody, it is parasmi pada. And if it is anything else than swarita or anudata, or if it is anything else than nit and nit, it is going to be parasmi pada. So, that we now know what is atmani pada and what is parasmi pada. Now, at this point, he says, vartamane lat. Vartamane lat. Vartamane lat. So, he says, vartamane lat. Vartamane lat is the sutra which defines vartamane lat. Saptami here, this is seventh case. This is first case. Saptami here is not taken in the general sense like when follows like that. Vartamana arthe, in artha sense also saptami is used in sutras. So, vartamana arthe, when you are going to use the present tense, vartamana means present tense. So, when you are going to use present tense, you have to use lat. Lat is the usage. With dhatu, you have to bring in lat. Or dhatu plus lakara, this lakara should be lat lakara. Like this you can say. In vartamana arthe. Vartamana arthe dhatu plus lakara, underline lakara and say lat lakara. Now, we know bhu is the dhatu which we are going to use here. Okay. So, with bhu dhatu, we need to bring in lat lakara. Bhu plus lakara. See, I brought this vartamani lat here, though we are going to discuss only the general sutras. I brought lakara, lat lakara here to make us understand better some sutras which will be common for all the other places. So, bhu plus lat. In lat, takara is a tit halantyam. Then, lakara, no, not lakara, akara. Akara is a upadeshe. So, we have bhu plus lakara. This is lat lakara, bhu plus lakara. In this place, you have to bring in the pratyas. What pratyas we will bring? This is kartari. Kartari prayoga. We are only doing kartari prayoga. This is application of kartari. Present tense. Now, in present tense, not present tense, in active voice, bhu plus lat. In lakara place, and this is bhu. This is not udata, swarita, nit or nit. Therefore, parasmai pada. It is not atmani pada, it is parasmai pada. Parasmai pada means tiptasji, siptasta, nibbasmas. Okay? I am going to bring in bhu plus mas. Tiptasji, siptasta, nibbasmas. This is parasmai pada. In the place of lakara, I am going to bring in this. At this point, The sutra says, Tringas trini trini prathamadhyamottamaha, Tanyekavachana divachana bahuvachana anyekashaha. There, this is the present case. And asmadyovade, asmadi uttamaha, sheshe prathamaha prathama. So, I am going to bring in prathama ekavachana. So, bhu plus ti. All these sutras should come. Like in sup, su of just, when you are to add sup, then in the place of sup, you just chose su because of all those sutras. In the same way here also, you have to understand bhu plus ti. At this point, there is other sutra which says kartari shap. So, kartari artha, we are doing kartari. So, in kartari artha, with the dhatu, you need to bring in shap. Kartari arte dhatoho shap syat. That will be the vritti. Kartari arte dhatu plus lakara shap. You will have to bring in for the dhatu shap. In shap, shakara is it lashakvat adhite, pakara is it halantyam. Halantyam lashakvat adhite. So we have bhu plus following the dhatu. It is not for the dhatu. Yasmat pratyaya vidhistadadi pratyaya engam, this becomes anga. Following the anga, you have to bring in the pratyaya because this is a pratyaya. Shap is a pratyaya. Pratyaya is not a replacement. Pratyaya is not an injunct. Pratyaya only follows the dhatu, follows the place of application. So, here it follows the place of application which is a bhu. Shap plus a in the place of lat, you have brought ti. So now, after removing the shakara and pakara, you have bhu plus a plus ti. Bhu plus a plus ti. At this point, next sutra comes and says, sarvadhatuka ardhadhatuka yoho. This is a very common sutra. Sarvadhatuka ardha dhatuka yoho. I am splitting it for convenience sake. So, sarudhatuka ardhadhatuka yoho. Whether sarudhatuka is for the seventh case, whether sarudhatuka follows or ardhadhatuka follows, there is no change. The only thing is the dhatu gets dhatu when followed by sadha or ardha dhatuka. Sarudhatuka or ardhatuka, dhatu gets a guna. Iganta anga of dhatu. Iganta anga of the dhatu gets a guna. That is what the sutra says. Iganta anga gets guna when followed by sarudhatuka or ardhatuka. Now, in bhu, do we have iganta anga? E-U, rul, ru, iganta. You have U. Okay? So, it is iganta anga. So, and it is followed by shap. Shap is sarudhatuka. Ting is also shan. Ting shit sarudhatukam. So, it is sarudhatuka. It is followed by sarudhatuka. Therefore, bhu gets guna. What is the guna for bhu? According to sarudhatuka, bho. So, according to the sarudhatuka ardhatuka yoho, you get a guna. So, for bhu, you get a bho plus a plus ti. Okay? Bho plus a plus ti. O plus a plus ti. I am splitting it. Bhakara plus O plus A plus T. O plus A, H O Yava Yavaha.
So, au. In the place of o, you have au plus a plus ti. I add bhava ti. This is a prathama ekavachana.
Here, the bhava portion will be common. The kartari shabd will come for all the forms of letter. So, kartari shabd will come and the guna, sardhatika ardhatika yoho, guna will take place. Therefore, bhava will be common. You have to bring in only tip, tas. Tip, tas. Same sutras, all the other sutras are same. So, bhava portion will be common. Thus, I will bring in, I will add this, bhavata sashashuru karasardhi visarjaniha bhavati. This is prathama divachana. Tiptas g, bhava plus g. For this, there is next sutra called jhontaha. Jhontaha.
It's a special sutra.
The sutra says,
jho jaha antaha.
Jaha antaha.
Sutra says, jhakara gets ant adesha.
Jhakara gets ant adesha.
Jho antaha.
Pratyayavasya.
Of the pratyayava. Pratyaya. Jhakara gets ant adesha. Not full j, g.
Jonta, the whole j, g will not get ant.
Only jhakara will get ant adesha. Therefore, I will bring in, get jontaha. Bring in jontaha. If I bring jhakara anta, bhava plus ant plus e. Bhava plus ant plus e. Right here. Bhava plus jhakara plus e. For jhakara, jhontaha, I bring in ant plus e. Bhava plus ant plus e. Bhava plus anti.
At this point, we studied one sutra, ato gune. Here, a plus a, it is not a akasavarni dirgaha. Don't bring an akasavarni dirgaha, because this is anga akara, anga anta akara, akara anta anga, this is a. So, this is a pratyadi akara. So, when you bring ato gune, pururupa ekadesha takes place, guna ekadesha takes place. So, bhava nati. This is prathama bahuvachana. Bhavati bhavatah bhavanti. Bhavati bhavatah bhavanti.
Bhavati bhavatah
bhavanti.
So the rest of the sutras are very simple. We have bhava plus a sip.
Bhava plus sip.
Then sip pit halantyam bhava plus si. Bhava si. Bhava plus thas.
Sasashuruhu kravasani visarjaniha
bhava thas bhavataha. Bhava plus tha. I am just adding it. Bhavatha.
Bhavasi bhavataha bhavatha.
Bhavasi bhavataha bhavatha.
Madhya Purusha. Bhavasi bhavataha bhavatha.
Bhavasi bhavataha bhavatha.
Then, for the Uttama Purusha, you have a special sutra.
Ato dirgo yayi.
You have a special sutra called Ataha
Dirgaha. E aí? E aí, seventh case? Dirgaha. First case? Ataha. Sixth case. For Adanta Anga. For Adanta Anga, Dirga takes place when followed by Yai Adi Pratyaya. When followed by Yai Adi Pratyaya, Adanta Anga gets Dirga. So we have Bhava plus Mip. In the Mip, Akara is it, we have only Ni. Okay? Harantyam. We have Bhava plus Mi. Right? Bhava plus Mip. Mip. Harantyam. Bhava plus Mi. This Mi is Yaya Adi Pratyaya. Yaya means it starts with Ya, ends with Nyakara. Yavara La Nyamangana Na Jabha. In that, Makara is there. So, Mi is a in plus E. So, it is Makara Adi, Yayadi. Therefore, the Adanta Anga should get a Dirga. Bhava plus Mi. Bhava Mi. Bhava Mi. In the same way, Ato Dirga Yi will be also for a Vas and Mas. Bhava plus Vas. Now, Ato Dirga Yi. Vas is also Hayava. It's also in Yi. So, you have Ato Dirga Yi. Bhava Vas. Sasa Shuru Karasaram Sardaniya. Bhava, Vaha. If I am going to bring in Masa, again the same thing. Bhava, Bhava plus Mas. Ato Dirgo Yi. Bhava plus Mas. Sasha Shuru Krasana Vasaradaniha. Bhava, Maha. So, Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha.
Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha.
Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha.
Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha.
Uttama Purusha. Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha. So we have Bhavasi, no, Bhavati Bhavataha Bhavanti. Bhavasi Bhavataha Bhavata. Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha. Bhavati Bhavataha Bhavanti. Bhavasi Bhavata Bhavata. Bhavami Bhavavaha Bhavamaha. So, Bhavati is Prathama Purusha Ekvachana. This is Madhyama Purusha, this is Uttama Purusha. Pratham Purusha. He goes. They two go. They all go. Bhavasi. You go. You two go. You all are going. He is going. He. They two are going. They all are going. You are going. Or you. Yes, this is not going. No, this is existing. Bhu Sattayam. So, he exists, he is, they two are, they all are. You are, you both are, you both, you all are. I am, we both are, we all exist like that, okay? In existence, artha. So, is and are is good enough. So, that is the meaning. He, they, he, you, I. They two, you two, we two. They all, you all, we all. That is the meaning. Okay?
So we will see Parokshi little next time. Harihi Om.